fortune of having four parents, basically. My mother was a homemaker. My stepfather drove 18-wheelers for UPS. My father was, for the most part, a county planner for Alameda County, but he did retire as a, you know, kind of a head of the administration group for Alameda County. And then my stepmother, who's actually the only one still working, has been in marketing her whole career.
What pushed you towards technology?
Yeah, interesting question. Someone who had a big impact on my life was my grandfather, my mom's dad. He was born in Oakland to immigrant parents. He went to Cal. He was a pilot in World War II. He flew B-25s in Asia. And he came back. He became an engineer. He ran his own engineering firm, so he was an entrepreneur. He was an inventor. He did a lot of really cool and interesting things. And so he bought me my first computer when I think I was 12. And the memory was on a cassette tape. And I remember I was trying to build it was a card game or something. And you type this whole thing out. And if you had one syntax error and it didn't tell you where, you had to start all over again.
Good luck.
Yeah. So, he had a huge influence on me. He had two daughters and one grandchild, me. So he was like a third dad for me, that's for sure. He lived here in the Bay Area, so I got to see him a lot growing up. And even as an adult, he and I would talk quite a bit.
Sounds like a Renaissance man. Did a little bit of everything.
Yeah, he did do a little bit of everything. He invented... you know, the stud finder.
Oh, yeah.
In the house. Yeah. He invented some oven for, do you remember, what were those cookies? Otis Spunkmeyer.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He invented an oven for them that they could cook more cookies and get the same results.
Wow. That's great. And what was his name?
His name was Jerry. Jerome Gizditch.
Jerome sounds like a cool guy. You know, you got to have those people in your life. And it's like, I was going to ask, are you an only child?
Yes and no. I have two step sisters, a step brother, and I have a half sister, who is, 20 years younger than me.
Okay.
So, I'm not, but I did grow up in the house kind of by myself, so kind of grew up as an only child.
Okay. Yeah, I'm an only child, and there's plenty of attention was given to me. You know, and I've got my wife grew up with four older brothers, and it's just a completely different way of being raised. So you said before, where did you go to high school?
James Logan.
And were you a good student?
I did well. Maybe it's kind of an interesting story for right now. I think growing up when I was much younger, it came naturally. So, you know, people say, well, you're smart or whatever. And so you did well without really trying. But James Logan was a big school. It's like 4,500 students. And there's a lot of competition, and I was playing baseball at the time as well. So trying to balance being a student and an athlete, and most of my friends were not good students, so I didn't have like good role models there. And after my so I did well, but then I was just doing kind of okay. Let's say my first 2 years of high school. And I went on a trip with my dad that summer before my junior year. I think my sophomore year, I got mostly B's. And I went to all these schools that I want, you know, thought I would want to go to, and was looking, you know, going to the admissions offices and thinking to myself, there's no way I'm going to get into this school. The B's aren't cutting it. I had this sort of epiphany, I remember, before I started my junior year. And I said, I got to run the table with A's, like, period. There's no other option. I have to run the table with A's. And I did that.